Hi guys, Mel the Train Tutor here again with another tutorial for you. Right guys, I've had a few comments about how I did the trees for the Broken Spirit build, and if you haven't seen them before, here's a couple of photos. Well, as you can see, they're quite cool trees. Now, these are wire armature trees. I have made the trees myself, okay? And to be perfectly honest, I've made absolutely tons of trees. I used to make them in my mum's craft shop when I was a kid, and they used to be gem trees, okay? And the principles are exactly the same. Basic tools you're going to need some wire, okay? You're going to need some clippers, preferably to watch color, also a pair of pliers, and then you're going to need some milliput or some sort of putty and a sculpting tool for the bark. Now, this video is purely about making the trees and the armatures, etc. In the next video, we'll look at all the various clumpologies, ways of painting them, etc. But this one's purely about making the basic trees. Okay, now I've got a selection of wire here. The Broken Spirit ones I used 1.6 mil aluminium wire, which is quite thick. Okay, now what I've got here is I've got some 1 millimeter wire, there's some 0.7. When I was doing the gem trees, we used to use 0.2. Now, the thickness it depends on how many branches you want, because essentially, the thinner it is, the more strands you have, and therefore the more branches you have. Now, I'm doing these for clump foliage trees. Yeah. And on that basis, I don't need that many branches, so I'm using millimeter stuff. And the first thing you need to do is obviously, unwrap it. So let's spin that off quickly. So there, and then spin that one off. Right, there we go. Okay, now when it comes to sizes, I tend to go round about the 20 centimeter mark. Okay, which is approximately there. Okay, and the reason for that is I have a third, approximately 3 or 4 centimeters of the roots. I have 10 centimeters, or just over 2 inches as the trunk, and then I have another 7 centimeters as the actual for the actual branches. Okay, and what I'm going to do is with my 20 centimeter length, I'm going to start to do loops. And I'm going to want about 15 loops. So that's 1, 14, 15. Right, where's that last end there? So I need to just bring that one around like that. Okay, and then clip it off. Right, so there's my 15 loops. Okay. And as you can see, I literally have done loops and loops and loops and loops. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take two metal files. Okay, now I'm going to do this with the first one. I'm just going to put it through the loops and very quickly give it a twist. Yeah. The next job is put it through the top loops. Takes a little bit of feeding. Like that, yeah. So it's through all the top loops, put the other one through there. Yeah, and then what I can start to do is start to twist these. I mean, you can try and just twist them with your hands. I prefer to watch what they get these in because I get a better twist. Need a bit more of a twist there. Okay, and as you twist them, it will take a trunk-like shape. Okay. Now, obviously, I've got the bottom bit and I've got the top bit. The first bit I'm going to do is my roots. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is twist this back a bit and start spreading these out. And I want, say, 3 or 4 clumps of them. So one set of loops there, one set of loops there, one set of loops there. Okay. So as you can see, I've just grabbed a few different loops, bent them out. And the next job I need to do is put that through again and then twist those into trunks. Yeah. And this is what's going to make up the actual roots of the build. So very quickly bend that around there so we get that. As you can see, there are our basic roots. Okay, and very quickly with my pliers, squash those down a bit. as you can see, they're your basic roots. Now you can take more time, you can watercolour, make them more detailed, you can spread them out further like we're going to do with the branches. But the idea behind this is just a basic idea of how to do the wire armatures. We'll look at doing all that funky stuff in another video. So all I'm doing is just taking the excess loops off so they don't stick out too far. Yeah, and on that one as well. And there we have it, there's my roots in place. Right, the next thing I need to do is actually turn these into branches. And it's a bit like the roots, etc. It's a bit more involved. So I'm going to break them off. I'm breaking them into groups. And I want to go a bit lower. Yeah, next group. Let's spin it around a bit. Yeah, they'll go. And then let's keep those together for a second. So here we've got, I've bent two loops off. Once again, we do the twist thing. And I'm gripping it quite far down, because if I grip it down here, I get the twist here. Okay, if I grip it up here, it'll start twisting up here. So I want to grip it quite close and then pull it off from there. Same on that one. Yeah, that's good. Keep that there. And then what we'll do is we'll spread these out a bit. So that one can come off there. These two can carry on. So very quickly, carry on twisting that one. And then very quickly carry on twisting these before spreading them into two separate branches. Yeah. And there you have it. And as you can see, as I'm twisting and breaking it off, sort of cutting off at different points, I suppose you could say, and sort of splitting at different points, you start to get the armatures of the arms, etc. So I'm going to carry on with this. I'll fast forward the video as I go. It's all twisted up now, as you can see. Yeah, and I've got all my loops at the end. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to have a play with the general shape of it. Okay, so let's move that around there. And basically what I'm looking to do is to make sure I've got a reasonable bit of coverage, you know, from the actual piece. And by coverage, I mean spread. Okay, so as you can see, it's sort of sticking out like that. I'm going to need some gaps because I need to create sort of a negative space underneath it. Okay, because trees aren't just clumps. They're sort of, they have the foliage on the outside. Okay, and on the inside, they're actually sort of bare, if you know what I mean. And you remember what it's like as a kid climbing up inside a tree. You could hide inside them. Okay, so all I'm doing is just moving these around. And the next thing I need to do is come in and just start clipping these loops. So what I'll do is that off. Now, what I could do, of course, is just clip that there and use those as individual branches and spread them out, and that's what you normally do. Okay, but I'm covering all of this with modeling putty, so I want them to be quite short. Yeah, so I'm going to trim them down to the base of the twist. Obviously, if you've got lots and lots of thinner wires, then you're going to have a larger structure. Now, depending on how many sort of wires you have, depends on how many branches you want, because essentially each wire is one final branch or one final twig coming off. Yeah, so if you want lots, you need to use thinner wire and lots of it. You know, if you're only after clump foliage trees, then you can get away with thicker wire, and because, you know, you're going with larger clumps, so you want something a little bit sturdier to stick them to. Let's keep that one. That length, twist that out a bit, and then very quickly just squeeze it down. Okay, and there's a loop there as well. Okay. So very quickly trim that, and then trim that. Okay, and there you have it. That is how you twist up a basic tree armature. Now, obviously, you know, we're a long way from finished yet, guys, but as you can see, it's actually starting to take shape. Okay, have I got a model quickly?
Yeah, here's a relics.
There you are. So as you can see, still a little bit tall, but that's going to be going on a base. I could probably pull the arms down a bit and lower it down a bit. So it reduce the trunk height. Looks like Groot. There you go. That's a bit better. Okay, right. Next bit that we're going to do is I'm going to put it on a hot glue base. So I'm going to go get my hot glue gun. I'm back in a second. The next bit is optional, okay? It's just something I prefer to do. So back in a second, guys. So here's the next stage. As you can see, I've got my hot glue ready. I've also taped down some greaseproof paper, some kitchen greaseproof paper. And the reason for this is hot glue doesn't stick to it. Yeah, and so what I can do is I can look at my base. Yeah, I can flatten down the roots just to make sure they go nice and flat. And then what I'm going to do is essentially build up a hot glue base for it. And I'm going in roughly a sort of a triangular pattern. Yeah. While it's still hot, get my branches and put them in. Sorry, my roots, not my branches. And then very quickly, I'm just going to go around the edge and just make sure that all the way round the actual metal armatures, the metal wires are covered to the actual edge. Yeah, a bit more there, little bit more there. Right, and then all we need to do now is leave that to dry. Right, guys, so there we have it, and it's all dry now. And as you can see, because it's what you call it greaseproof paper, you know, it's given me a nice flat base to work from. I've also zoomed the camera in a bit for this bit so you can see what I'm doing. So let me just move that out of the way. Right, guys, it's right around my finger. Okay, what I've got here is I've got some standard, what you call it, red milliput. Okay, and if you've never come across milliput before, it's just a two-part epoxy putty. Yeah, you mix it together, it stays pliable for a while, you can sculpt in it, etc., sand it when it's dry. And but the most important thing with milliput is when it dries, it goes really, really hard, which for trees, you know, because they're bendy, okay, it just works better. It holds them better than things like das modeling putty or filler. You could use green stuff, yeah, but it'd be expensive. Yeah, milliput's like £2 a pack. Now I've been messing around with the branches and twisting them while it, you know, that's been drying, just basically getting a decent shape. So that's what I'm going for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start breaking these little bits off. And the first point is I want to fill the big gaps where the big twist is and where the big twist is at the bottom. So I'm literally coming along and just pushing it in. Now it does help if you have a damp cloth, just to keep smoothing over your fingers, etc., because it is a bit sticky and a bit messy. Yeah. So I want to get that just over there. And just set that. Now, normally I'd recommend doing this over stages so you can work on a bit, sculpt a bit, and then come back to it. Yeah, but we're just going to work through for this one. Yeah, and with this one, yeah, I'm just putting it around the bottom and just filling in those gaps. I'm not too concerned about the shape just yet because, like I say, it's really pliable. It's more about getting the coverage. And then what we want to do is cover the wires at the bottom, the roots. So three little sausages. Actually, straight on top. And then just give them a good fingering down. Once again, really work it in with your hands. That's the best way to get good results. You know, take your time, attention to detail. There we go. And as you can see, the rough roots are in place. I know it's out of focus. I've got the focus locked down here, guys, but I'll bring you some photos. You can see what I'm doing. Next one I'm going to do is a nice long sausage. Yeah, and we get the sausage and we're just going to wrap it around the tree. And I'm following the wires with this one. Yeah, press it in just a little as it goes on down. And then just pull off and give a good tug on whatever the excess is. Yeah, and then all I'm doing is I'm just working it round and pushing it into these wires. Yeah, wet my fingers a little, get them nice and slippy rather than sticky. See, that's what happens when it gets sticky. It sticks to you. So a bit of water here, just to really wet my fingers up, so it slides nice and easy. And then just carry on working that putty all around those armatures. There you go. Yeah, get the other bit and start filling the gaps. As you can see, it gets really messy. Yeah. Sticky fingers. So like I say, make sure you've got a cloth handy and some water. Okay. All right, grab another bit. Into a roll. And then start patching the last little bits, like this bit here. You know, where there's wires showing. So literally press down a little bit, pull off the excess, look for another gap, press it down. Yeah, and cover those wires there as well. Just those last few bits. Now you might get the odd wire just poking through. Don't worry about that. You can disguise it later. So I'm going to leave a few. Yeah, show you how we can disguise them. Yeah, but all I'm working now is I'm just working my fingers round it just to sort of smooth it all out, ready for when we get to the sculpting stage. Have I left any? Yeah, there's some wires down there. I'll need to cover those ones. There's a bit too much. A little bit in there. What's that big one? There. Okay, and there's the basic trunk covered. Yeah, and the roots. Next thing to do is we're going to work on the arms. So, now normally I would let this dry and do the trunks, so to speak, and sculpt the trunks, and then do the arms separately. But for this one, we'll just go straight for it. Yeah. Now, I don't need to get as much putty on these because I'm not going to be sculpting heavy sort of bark texture into them that much because they're going to be under the clump foliage anyway. Ooh, wet my fingers. So it's just a matter of getting the wires covered and making them solid and getting rid of that sort of wire texture. Right. Right, there's our fully, what you call it, sort of covered piece. Now it's quite sort of gappy and joiny, and there's a few wires. So what I'm going to do now is wet my fingers, yeah, and just start running over the model. Okay, and what I'm trying to do is just basically blend all the joins in, yeah, redefine the roots. Oh, I need to go around that and just clean that up with a scalpel afterwards. I'll do that once it's all dry anyway. I don't have to do it right now. Yeah, so work it up and down the trunk. Yeah, see if I can get those roots defined in. Yeah, up to the branches. Once again, another messy job, but just go with it. Do your best to blend it in and cover up the wires. Sometimes it can be quite challenging. Yeah, but as long as you can get the majority of the wires covered, especially on these branches, because these branches are going to be up and covered by clump foliage anyway. So you've got a bit of leeway with those. See how the base makes it a lot easier to work with. You can also see why normally I'll leave them to dry first and do the trunks and then come back and do the branches, because it does get messy. I've got wires showing there, so I need to work that round. That's better. Same there. Now you can use clay shapers and things like that to sort of shape these things up. Yeah, it depends. Like all terrain, it really depends on how much time you want to put into it. You know, the more time you put into it, the better the build. Yeah, and all I'm doing on this one is just basically showing you the basic techniques for building these. We'll cover all the advanced stuff in a future watch of the vid. But if I can show you how I did the broken spirit ones, then, you know, I'll be happy with this vid. It's nice to be doing tutorials as well. Right, cover that up. There's a bit of wire showing, so I'm trying to drag the putty over it. That's it. Right, and there you have it. As a quick job, that's not too bad. Right, the next job we've got to do is to actually start sculpting in the bark. Okay, so let me clear that off. Yeah, and to do this, yeah, I'm going to hold it by the base and I'm going to use a standard sort of hobby sculpting tool. Yeah, plenty of water. And the basic technique is just to put lots and lots of lines into it. Yeah, and what will happen is these lines will start to join up and it will give you a bark texture. I'm not going to worry too much about the bark on these branches here. Okay, I'm mainly going to do the trunk and the main branches because, like I say, these ones are going to be covered with clump foliage anyway. Yeah. Long lines and what you call it, lots of little short ones works really well. Now, what I'm going to do is very quickly, I'm just going to crack on with this and just sculpt these lines in. Next up, now I've done all the branches, etc. What I'll do is I'll save the autofocus until I get to the end. I'm just going to do the actual trunks, the roots, sorry. Yeah, and just lots of little lines coming down in parallel with the log and then sort of folding over to the side. Now, remember, yeah, that we're going to be putting grit around the base, so you don't have to worry about getting it perfect. Yeah, you've just got to get that top texture. So I'm working on the top texture here on this one. And there you have it, guys. Now, basically, what I've done is it's all based, all the bark texture is on all the major trunks. Now, let me quickly switch to what you call it, autofocus. There you go. It's probably, you can probably see it now. Typical. Right, I'm going to bring it up nice and close up to the camera so you can actually see that bark fat. Okay, yeah. Focusing, come on. Come on, focus, you nasty. Come on, focus on me. There you go. As you can see, by putting all those little lines down it, what we've managed to do is create a very realistic, what you call it, sort of bark texture. Now you notice there's lots of little bumps on it. Okay, now these bumps are just from the scrapings of where I've been scraping. And I'm leaving those on because they add to the texture of the piece. Now I've only barked up to the branches, yeah, because of the tail end of the branches, okay, all those are going to be what you've got covered in flocking material or clump foliage or whatever I decide to go with this one. Yeah, but as you can see, there's the roots. Right, focus in on it, guys. Can you focus? There you are. Yeah. So that's basically, yeah, how you make the wire armature of the trees. Okay. Now, what we're going to be doing in an upcoming vid is we'll look at basing them, painting them, and what you call it, and adding various different flocks and foliage, not flocks. We'll be adding what you call it, clump foliage, yeah, to this one or lichen or something like that. Yeah, I haven't decided what we'll do on this one yet. But that's it. That's how you make wire armatures, guys. Come back in a future vid, and once I've got it all dried and everything, I'll paint it up, and we can look at what you call it, getting it all bushed out and looking like a proper tree. Right, guys. Hope you found it interesting. As always, yeah. If you like it, throw a like on it. If you've done this before, or you've got any questions or anything like that, just give me a shout. Yeah, throw it in the comments. Yeah, if you've got any tips or any different ways of doing it. Always glad to hear more stuff. And if you're new to the channel, yeah, click subscribe, guys. Plenty more terrain tutorials coming soon. In the meantime, yeah, I'm going to let this dry and I'm going to crack on filming a different tutorial because I'm trying to get caught up on my tutorials. So you have a good day, yeah, and I will see you soon. All the best. Ta-ra.